Hello everyone, it's Laffy Traffy. I'm here with my review of One Piece Chapter 1002, Yonko, Four Emperors versus the New Generation. If you haven't, check out my reaction video to this chapter. Otherwise, let's dive right in to the continuation of the greatest fight ever. At least since I've been reading weekly. I mean, Luffy versus Katakuri was amazing, but this is on another level. The chapter has a nice, calming cover art of Lucci feeding some stylish pigeons. Hattori's food, as Hattori watches on sadly. Seems that the pigeons were bullying him a bit, but we'll just go on to the chapter. The chapter picks up right where we left off with another fight-filled chapter of action. Kaido opens up with his demolition gusts as they all dodge and Kid loses his left arm. Again. I'm a little confused though because it looked like the arms were just floating there, but then it got sliced off. If it's floating, it doesn't matter if it's sliced. It's all broken metals and scrap anyway, as Kid pointed out. So I'm sure he can just keep levitating the arms and keep fighting without issue. Law, Luffy, and Killer all sidestep and avoid the attack, but Zoro, however, deflects the gust slice and is looking real serious. Rereading it, this was very nice foreshadowing to his more serious attack later on, but we'll get there. Also, this exact attack was invisible, as mentioned when the scabbards were assaulted by it, and it was also the one that took Kiku's arm off and broke her sword. This is a testament to Zoro's power, as he just nonchalantly redirects it, like, nope, not today, we mean business. Now, the captain combo attack was super cool. Luffy punched Kaido backwards, Kid grabs him and suplexes him down, and then Law takes that opening to do Gamma Knife! It was solid. I am all here for the combos. Unfortunately, Kid is still lacking a bit, considering Kaido fell from Sky Island and didn't get hurt, so what is his wrestling moves gonna do? But I'm still waiting for some creativity for Kid to overcome this. Law's Gamma Knife was as amazing as his one-liners. The heart should be around here. Really though, on one hand, Law needs to do more damage, but on the other hand, attacks like Gamma Knife really drain his stamina. And I'm surprised, but at the same time not, that Kaido didn't really get affected by Gamma Knife. It put Doflamingo on the ground. Kaido's tanking all of this. Kaido references them overcoming his durability, at least referencing Law and Luffy at the time. So we know something's being done to him. But yeah, I just don't believe Kid is part of that. Sorry, there's just no way Kid is hurting him. Killer, however, was mega impressive. This sonic scythe move was just visually really awesome, as well as clearly did some damage to Kaido. This makes me feel a whole lot better with Killer being here. I mean, what else does he have in store? Will he just spam this attack, or does he have more? We'll see. Also, fun fact, I learned recently that there's a song by the Talking Heads called Psycho Killer that Killer's inspired by. There's even a fa-fa-fa-fa-fa part, which, yep, it's his laugh. Just some fun trivia. Anyway, Killer was right up there with Zoro in my eyes for this chapter, for dealing some solid hits and proving he deserves to be up there. Kid, take some notes. Now, we again get a poor Law not wanting to be anyone's servant. The first time was funny, but now it seems like it's a pattern, and I feel like Law's exasperation may come into play. We're thinking he'd be good to manipulate the battlefield, but he seems to get pretty pissed when someone asks him to do just that. I'm hoping it's just for show and nothing too major, but we'll see how this goes as the fight progresses. I mean, he did end up shambling Zoro up to Luffy, so he did listen. He's smart and tactical, so he has to see that he's a solid support character in this battle, so long as he can overcome the ego. They all have it. And like I've said in my last review, I'm really excited to see when they all put their rivalry aside and fight as a unit.
Monkey together strong.
So as Zoro gets teleported up there, he slices the blast Boral breath in half. And I really like how Luffy is so impressed with Zoro. He's being an MVP for attacking Kaido while also saving Luffy from carelessness. Of course, Luffy doesn't need it. Well, maybe he does. But we never get to see these two fight together. When was the last time? Thriller Bark? And that was all the Straw Hats, so this is still different. I'm loving this duo team-up right here. So now we see Zoro going in for his long-awaited slash with Enma. But the way Kaido's reacting, I feel like he's gonna get another PTSD flashback of Odin. I'm actually surprised he didn't in this chapter. Just the build-up of Zoro's attack. Of Kaido's dragon senses tingling and Big Mom telling him to get the f*** out of the way. Just that sends respects to Zoro. This is the only attack Kaido has even cared enough to dodge. And if he didn't? Let's not get ahead of ourselves, but I think he'd be looking rough. Big Mom, however, is standing strong. I wonder how long this will go on, but the Supernova are all so preoccupied with attacking Kaido that Big Mom hasn't gotten a single attack even launched at her, let alone any damage taken. But flip that around and she's over here carrying Kaido through this fight. No, I'm mostly kidding. But she saved him from Killer, warned him from Zoro. She's dishing out some solid attacks too that got Zoro and Killer straight on. Plus, I'm still confused rereading this several times, but it looks like the lightning bolts that she's using themselves are homies that she has. They can zoom right onto a target because they're sentient. This was a really cool move by her, and I am loving Hype Big Mom. It's about time she starts showing what kind of monster she really is. Of course, her lightning doesn't affect Luffy as he shouts, "I'm made of rubber!" And she's over here, surprise Pikachu phase. I just imagine Enaru is on the moon right now, watching the fight with some popcorn, chilling with his automaton army, and he's just like, "Yep, tell me about it, girl." So going towards the end of the chapter, Luffy, very similarly to the opening, runs through Kaido's Boro Breath. You can see all the other ones are taken out and trying to dodge the lightning, and Luffy tanks the lightning, of course, and then tanks the Boro Breath. And Kaido is pretty surprised, and so are we. And Luffy just shouts that it's guts, and then he goes in with a gum gum Kong Gatling. So my interpretation of this is it's definitely Ryo. Some people are saying that it is actually just guts, willpower, shonen magic, but it has to be Ryo. The way I see it, I think it's a very Luffy thing to say guts, rather than monologue about his new haki. "Well, Kaido, you see, when we first met, I had nothing to damage you. But now, I have trained under Master Hiyo and learned advanced armament of—" No. He's telling Kaido, "You like what you see? It's called guts!" Until proven one way or another, I'm going with it's Ryo. They've described it as invisible armor, and I think this is a great way for Luffy to start countering these big attacks. It's on par with his training. Now the chapter ends with the smacking down of Kaido with the big King Kong Gatling, just adding up that damage onto Kaido. Overall, I think Big Mom finally showed a little more balance on her side with finally landing some attacks on the Supernova. Don't get me wrong, I know this fight is going to be tough. I'm just saying we haven't necessarily seen it yet, which makes me nervous. When things are going well, and we all know that they shouldn't be, there's cause for concern. Act 3 ends in a tragedy, and it's going to be ending sometime soon. We've been in this one for a while, so we'll see. All in all, the most hype I was for this chapter was the last page, where there's no break next week. Let's go. I'm excited to see if we're getting 4 fight chapters in a row. God, I hope. So thank you so much for watching, and make sure you subscribe. I do One Piece chapter reactions and reviews, as well as a series on the One Piece anime comparison with the manga. Go check it out and let me know what you think. I also stream fun chill games with my friends over on Twitch, so follow me there, and Twitter. Anyway, have a great day, follow your dreams, and check me next time. Bye!